One of the best things about advances in agricultural productivity is that they tend to spur industrial revolutions. Consider Indonesia. The country's economy has had its ups and downs, but overall, over the last few decades, it has emerged as an industrializing, exporting nation. The industrializing processes of the 1980s were in fact preceded by about 15 years of strong gains in agricultural productivity. During the 1970s, about 50 million Indonesians left poverty without the aid of export-oriented industry. This was because of agriculture. For instance, between 1968 and 1985, yields for rice, which is the staple food in Indonesia, rose by about 80%, and total rice production grew almost three times faster than population growth. In 1974, Indonesia was the largest rice importer in the world. By 1984, the country was self-sufficient in rice. Indonesia's green revolution was based in small farmers, it was mediated through markets, and the state played an important role in making available to farmers high-yielding, fertilizer-responsive rice varieties. Japan, Taiwan, and South Korea all have broadly similar histories in this regard. That is, their processes of industrialization were preceded by significant productivity gains in agriculture. These market developments were supported by their governments through building the right kinds of infrastructure, rural education, and in general supporting and encouraging research and development in agriculture, in addition to the more general role of those governments in creating a stable economic environment. Agricultural growth helps boost industrialization in a few ways. For one thing, the more productive is agriculture, the easier it is for some workers to shift from farms to factories in larger cities. Furthermore, agriculture produces a surplus, and this mobilizes domestic savings, which can be used to finance investment, as indeed was the case in the East Asian economic miracles. Finally, there may be an intangible effect. A country which has some success in agriculture starts to believe it can have economic success more generally. Interestingly, Japan, Taiwan, and South Korea all engaged in significant programs of land reform in the periods leading up to their industrialization. Basically, land was taken away from landlords and given to smaller farmers and tenants. Cause and effect are hard to disentangle here, but it seems that this may have boosted agricultural productivity, and it also may have contributed to a general sense of fairness and helped the later democratization of these countries. There was now a greater chance that these countries would have a stable middle class. Overall, information on these topics is fairly diffuse and spread out. You could try David Henley, The Agrarian Roots of Industrial Growth, or just Google East Asian Miracle Agriculture to get to some good sources.